Good morning, students. Myself Rashmi Yande, your science teacher. Stay home, stay safe, learn well.
Today we are going to start our first lesson, Heredity and Evolution. Here you have to first of all clear the concept about the heredity and evolution. Heredity, that is nothing but the transfer of the genetic material from parents to their offspring. Yes, evolution, it is a gradual changes occur in living organisms over a long duration. Here there is a relationship in between heredity and evolution. Here students, first of all, an introduction about the contribution of different scientists in the heredity and hereditary changes. As we know that Gregor John Mendel is pioneer of the modern genetics. He is the father of genetics. After his research, different scientists contribute their contribution to know what is the actual changes occurs and overall how this process is occurs. Okay, so here main three steps are there. As we know that genetics, it is related with the genes, that means the DNA, that is the deoxyribose nucleic acid, which is also called as the master molecule. If we look at here, this is the diagram of DNA, deoxyribose nucleic acid. Here it is a flexible ladder like structure where there is a pairing of the nitrogenous base. Adenine pair with the thymine, guanine always pair with the cytosine. These are the nucleotides, and here there is a pairing of these nucleotides is present. Now look at here, for heredity, which is responsible? Chromosomes are responsible, our DNA is responsible. Where is DNA present? DNA present on the chromosomes. Yes, chromosome, it is made up of nucleic acid plus protein. So for formation of that, we have to start protein synthesis. First point of this lesson, protein synthesis, this process complete into three steps: transcription, translation and translocation. Transcription, translation and translocation. First of all, transcription. In simple way, if the definition of transcription is about formation of or synthesis of mRNA from DNA. This is the structure of cell. Yes, in that cell, nucleus is present. In nucleus, nucleoplasm is there. In cell, cytoplasm is there. In nucleus, DNA is present. This DNA form mRNA, or this DNA synthesize the mRNA. And this process of synthesis of mRNA from DNA, it is called as the transcription. Here in first paragraph, listen carefully. With the help of RNA, the genes present in form of DNA participate in the functioning of cell and thereby control the structure and functioning of the body. Information about protein synthesis is already stored into the DNA. Whatever the information is required, whatever the things are required, it is always already present into the DNA. Yes, so these proteins are synthesized. These proteins are synthesized by DNA through RNA, and this is called as the central dogma. Overall protein synthesis process, which is covered, which is done by the DNA through RNA, it is called as the central dogma. And in that central dogma, transcription, translation and translocation, these three steps are there. This is the cell structure. In that, nucleus is present, DNA is present. From DNA, here mRNA is formed, that is the messenger RNA is formed. Messenger RNA initially present, form into the nucleus. After formation of mRNA, it come outside the nucleus. Okay, so here first step, that is the transcription, is over. First transcription is over. When there is a mRNA formation from DNA, transcription is over. Now second step, that is the translation. The mRNA form in nucleus comes into the cytoplasm. It brings encoded message from DNA. This ACGTT. Yeah, not the alphabets. These are the nucleotides. Yes, so they are present into the three pairs. Therefore, they are called as the triplet codon. While reading of this codon, we have to read that AUG, CAA or ACG, TTA. These type of triplet codons are present. Yes, the core for each amino acid consists of three nucleotides, which is called as the triplet codon. Total how many amino acids are there? 20 amino acids are there. Yes, a simple example I want to give you. We know that total 26 alphabets are there, A, B, C, D up to Z. But from these 26 alphabets, we can make different number of words. Like that, here 20 amino acids are present. But from these 20 amino acids, we can make the number of pair of this. Okay, so here mRNA carries the message. After that, second step is start, that is called as the translation. Translation, you know that the meaning of translation, you translate the paragraph in English paper or in language paper, you have to translate that paragraph into your mother tongue. That means whatever the sequence present on this mRNA, as per that, there is a pairing attachment from the tRNA is occur. You can observe that adenine pair with uracil, again uracil pair with adenine, uracil pair with adenine, uracil pair with adenine. Okay, so this is the code which is present on mRNA. That is the strip on which codons are present, and tRNA compensate pair with that codon by anticodon. So this type of pairing we can say that codon and anticodon pairing. Okay. Now each mRNA is made up of thousands of triplet codon. As per the message on mRNA, amino acids are supplied by the tRNA. That is the function of tRNA. Yes. For this purpose, tRNA has codon having complementary sequence to the codon on mRNA. So, whatever the code present on mRNA, tRNA attach the anticodon with proper sequence present on the mRNA. And this process it is called as the translation. The amino acids brought in by the tRNA are bonded together by peptide bonds with the help of rRNA. Now, third type of RNA here, rRNA, that is the ribosomal RNA. We know that when two molecules or two things get attached to each other, a bond is formed or a bond is necessary to attach two things. Yes, so here when codon and anticodon, they get bond, they get bind to each other, rRNA plays a role here, ribosomal RNA, and with the help of peptide bonds, there is an attachment of codon and anticodon. Okay, clear? During this process, the ribosomes keeps on moving from one end of mRNA to other end by the distance of one triplet codon, and this is called as the translocation. Translocation, that means whatever the tRNA carries the sequence, that sequence for matching purpose, it matching purpose with sequence on mRNA. Yes, for that purpose, it get change its place from one place to another place, and this process it is called as the translocation. Such a many chains come together to form a complex proteins. These proteins control various functions in the body of living organisms and their appearance too. क्यों चाहिए ये प्रोटीन सिंथेसिस? क्योंकि वी हैव टू अपीयर सर्टन कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स, वी हैव टू ट्रांसफर सर्टन कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स, वी हैव टू डू सर्टन फंक्शंस इनसाइड अवर बॉडी, एंड टू कंप्लीट दैट फंक्शंस वी रिक्वायर्ड प्रोटीन. एंड प्रोटीन सिंथेसिस, बाय द प्रोसेस ऑफ दिस प्रोटीन सिंथेसिस, देयर इज अ प्रोटीन फॉर्म एंड दैट वर्कआउट इज डन. Okay, and protein synthesis complete by these three steps. and protein synthesis complete by these three steps: transcription, translation and translocation. Okay, mutation, that is nothing but a minor changes may occur at the time of the pairing of this anticodon and codon. When codon and anticodon, they get bond with each other, make bond with each other, certain changes are occur. Okay, so proper definition of mutation is there. Sometimes any nucleotide of the gene changes its position, that causes a minor change, which is nothing but the mutation. As you can observe in diagram 1.3, main sequence is TAA, CTG, CAG. Yes, here in second pair, there is a change into that triplet codon. That is nothing but the mutation. That is nothing but the mutation. But when mutations, they are the minor, they are not considerable. But when mutation is occur in large pairings, which leads to the genetic disorders. You remember last year we discussed with certain genetic disorders, which are they? For example, Down syndrome, yes, after that Turner syndrome, Klinefelter syndrome, sickle cell anemia. These are the certain disorders which are called as the genetic disorders. Yes, that disorders occur due to the wrong pairing or chromosomal number abnormalities. So this is nothing but the concept of the mutation. Second part of this lesson, which is an important one, that is the evolution. Evolution, it is occur due to the heredity. We are similar to our parents, but we are not exactly 100% copy of our parents. Yes, certain variations are there. So this leads to the evolution. But evolution, it is a very slow process, gradual changes which are occur in living organism over a long duration, not in 1 year, 2 year, 1 month. This requires crores of years for evolution. For example, we know that we are evolved from the ape, that is the lemur. So evolution from that lemur to the Homo sapiens, that is the wise man, up to that different steps are there. Which steps are there? We know that Ramapithecus is there. Yes, after that Ramapithecus is there, Dryopithecus, skilled human, after that erect posture ke sath human, Neanderthal man, Cro-Magnon man. These are the different steps which are included into the journey of our development. This is the journey of our development, and it requires crores of years, which is called as the evolution, which is the next part of our lecture. We will continue later on. Okay, thank you students.